September 27th of 1994, my son died. He was 28 years old, and that changed my life and changed my direction. And it was at that point that God gave me a vision or a purpose. God opened the door, and the vision was, you need to build an orphanage here in Manzanillo. I know that God has a special place in his heart for the children. The Bible says in Matthew 18:10, be careful not to harm one of these little ones, because their angels always have the face of God. God always allows that messenger to speak on behalf of the children. God is always ready. And I believe that, and I saw it over and over again. And maybe a great portion of it has to do with faith and believing, but a lot of our people felt like, yes, this is part of God's work down here.
Cuando llegué a Casa Hogar tenía 8 años, en el 99. Fue algo, pues, doloroso al principio, porque pues era un niño y estar separado de mis padres, pues era como un doloroso, ¿no? Pues yo creo que Nancy es una persona maravillosa, de buen corazón, y yo la veo como una madre, un modelo a seguir.
Mandamiento con promesa en la Biblia es honra a tu padre y a tu madre, y es lo que tratamos de hacer con estos niños. Sin embargo, Casa Hogar Los Angelitos es la última opción, pero la mejor opción.
Every child that comes into the Casa Hogar comes in thinking there's something wrong with them. They're there because somebody didn't want them. I felt that way. I was living with my grandparents because my mother didn't want me. That's the way I felt. Or because my father died. It's a form of abandonment, whatever it might be. And I see them, and I see that sense of anger sometimes that's there. Why me? Why did this happen to me? And so that was a natural sense that I had inside of me, that I thought these children need to be doing something. And all of a sudden I'd see them change. I watched those children, some of those children just blossom like flowers. Within a short time period, they would start to smile, or they'd feel good or positive. And I thought, there's something to this. Oh, when my son died, I couldn't believe it. I could not believe it. Honestly, it's the greatest pain that anyone can feel. Better to die yourself. I'd lost, you know, people in my life, but to lose a child is just so heart-wrenching. No one could comfort me. My husband, no one, nothing helped me. The only thing that I found peace with, or a sense of peace, was in reading the Bible. The only comfort that I found.
Sí, la fe es la certeza de lo que se espera, es la convicción de lo que no se ve. Entonces, sin fe no podemos agradar a Dios. Y yo creo que la fe es, la veo en cada niño, en un niño que aparentemente no tiene un futuro. En Casa Hogar Los Angelitos tenemos fe de que ese futuro para el niño es enorme.
Y ahora pues le doy gracias a Dios por haberme puesto en este lugar, porque ahora pues ya soy, me dieron la oportunidad de estar aquí y de poder tener una carrera y estudiar. Y pues esa para mí fue la mejor experiencia que pude tener.
My son died September 27th, and in October, my husband decided that he wanted to go up to Colorado National Park, and I heard a voice, and that voice spoke to me, or to my spirit, and said, "Feed my children." And then the next day, I was walking our little dog, and I stopped to take a picture of a gnarly pine tree that was in the middle of the path. And I looked up, the same thing happened. And I heard a voice said, "Feed my children." So I thought, something is happening. Either God is speaking to me or I am truly losing my mind. So I went back and I started reading the Bible, and I started thinking, okay, where in the Bible does it talk about God speaking to you? And I turned to the story of Samuel, who was one of the great prophets of the Old Testament, and in the night heard a voice, Samuel, calling him, Samuel. And so Samuel got up and went to Eli, and he said, "Yes, Lord, I'm here." And Eli said, "I didn't call you. Go back to sleep." And in a little bit, he heard the voice again, "Samuel, Samuel." So he got up again and he went to Eli and he said, "Yes, Lord, I'm here. I heard you." And Eli said, "No, I didn't call you. That was the Lord." And the next time the Lord calls you, you answer. And as I was reading through again and I set my Bible down, again I heard the voice, "Feed my children." I closed my eyes and I said, "Lord, I believe it's you. I accept that. I'm your servant, and I will do whatever you want me to do." In March, my husband had invited me to take a little siesta in the afternoon. And as I started to doze off, I felt like someone was pulling me up like that. And I heard again this voice that said, "You have to build an orphanage here in Manzanillo. And it will be by my power and by my might. And I will bring the people when it's time, and you have to begin." And at that time, we had a young friend, a young man by the name of Felipe, and he came walking up and I called him up, Felipe, come on up. And so for the first time, I began telling someone else the things that had happened. And he said, "Yes, yes, it is of God." And I said, "Yes, I believe it is of God." And he said, no. "Last night, about 30 of us with our pastor from the church were praying until 3 or 4 in the morning that God would help us to help the children of Manzanillo. And he has answered our prayer."